1900s.
What's the good of these gramophone recordings? If you want to listen to music, then you should go to the concert hall and listen to a recital in person. How music is meant to be listened to. You can't possibly capture the soul and emotion of music in a recording.
1920s.
What's the good of all this radio technology? I don't need someone to tell me what to listen to. If I want to listen to something, I'll just play one of my gramophone records. It's so much nicer, and the sound is much better.
1950s.
These 45 revolution per minute records and their jukeboxes and rock and roll music. It's just screaming and shouting. And it only lasts for 2 minutes. I'd much prefer to sit down and listen to the radio. A good radio program will have someone tell you all about what you're listening to. And you can listen all day if you want.
1970s.
Back in the 50s and 60s, music was fun and exciting. You'd go down to your local shop and buy the latest 7-inch single and take it home and play it to death. It was just 2 to 3 minutes of fun and excitement. These days, everything is so over the top. All these so-called rock stars all need to have an image or a gimmick. And these concept albums are so pretentious with all that ridiculous artwork.
1980s.
Music's changed. Back in the 70s, buying an album meant something. There were real rock stars then, and everyone had an image, you know? You'd buy an album and play it at home, and you'd stare at the cover art and go on a journey. It's not the same today. Everyone tapes their friends' albums onto blank cassettes, so you lose that ritual of buying an album. And people tape songs off the radio, which is no good because half the time the DJ talks over the end of it.
1990s.
CDs just aren't the same as vinyl records. The sound isn't as good and they're so small. You can't enjoy the cover art like with a record. Records just had so much character. Even cassettes did in their own way. Everyone would tape each other's records and swap them with each other. And people would form these little networks of swapping tapes. Even when you'd tape songs off the radio, you know, sometimes the DJ would talk over the end of it, which was always quite funny. And the thrill of finding an old record in a second-hand shop. And the way it would smell, you know, it's not the same with CDs. They're so plastic.
The noughties.
Yeah, downloading music in MP3 form just doesn't have the charm of buying a CD. A CD was something you could hold and look at the artwork as you listen to it. Everyone had their favourite CD shops, and because you had to pay money for it, it was like an investment. You had more of a personal connection to it. And the thrill of finding an old, rare CD in a second-hand shop is something you don't have with downloaded music.
2020s.
Having music beamed into your head just isn't as good as it was. In my day, when you wanted some music, you'd have to physically download it yourself or copy someone else's MP3. It was good. It was a physical act, very interactive. Everyone would have their favourite websites to download from, and you'd have to wait a few minutes for it to download. So there was this anticipation and excitement that came with it, you know? And you'd have to play it on an actual device. It was so much nicer and simpler in those days.
2040s.
Yeah, back in the day where you'd get music instantly beamed into your head, it felt as though music really meant something, because it was being picked up by your own personal receiver that had to be surgically implanted in there by a licensed music seller. You had a very physical relationship with the music, and you could only store like 5 billion songs at a time, so it was like your own exclusive little collection. Unlike these days, with everyone wired into the great machine, this collective consciousness of all things we have now just isn't the same as it was.
2060s.
You know, ever since the collapse of the great machine, we don't have that nice shared experience with music that we had when we were all wired together. Now with this new mule technology world we live in, to listen to music, it's such a ritual. Everyone needs their own mule on a treadmill, and to hear a song, you need to ride the mule until the music orb inflates and then hovers above the frequency wand, and then you have to wait for it to pop and release that ink all over the music plate, and only then will the mule start playing the music. And all that ink seems to create these visuals for the music, which just takes away the magic of music.
2090s.
Yeah, I really don't like listening to music in these post-apocalyptic times. In my day, everyone had their own mule system, and there was a nice ritual you'd go through to listen to music. But now, with all the civilizations and all but a few life forms wiped out, to listen to music, you need to go out and see someone play it live. And it's always in an old hall or something. There's nothing personal and exclusive about it. It's this shared experience. It was better in my day.